All right, guys, we're here. TargetCon 2019. Let's go see what they got. It's currently 9 a.m. Had some stuff to do. Couldn't get there early, so hopefully we'll actually get something. I need that Vader. Let's go. All right, so it's been raining a while, and my shoes are squeaking, like squeak, 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 squeak. It's really annoying. Like, really. Get the pops. All right, so I'm gonna check the pops here in just a second, but I wanted to check the Black Series stuff and see if they got anything new. And they got this is not what I wanted, guys. This is in the wave of the stuff that I want, but this is not the one I want. So I don't think my battle droids are gonna be here, because I'm pretty sure somebody already grabbed them, which it's kind of stinks. I was here yesterday, and I wasn't here early enough, so somebody left me a holdo. Don't want this, but we're gonna go check out the pops and get those. It's freaking raining again. Target, lunchtime, going again. Why is it always gonna be raining? This is ridiculous. Why? It's been like 2 weeks of this nonsense. TargetCon 2019, round two. Again with the squeaking. All right, so had to get some work done. Now we're at Target number two. For TargetCon 2019, I'm hoping they still have some stuff, so I want to help some people out. So I got the ones I wanted earlier, so I'm hoping they got some more stuff here still, and I can help some of you guys out. So that's the hope. But I also want the freaking Black Series. Where are my figures? So here we go, guys. We got all this huge pop section here. This is stuff that's been here forever and ever and ever. So not really gonna go through all that, but they do have these, which are new. I showed these on a live stream a couple days ago. I think these are freaking cool. They've got him, they've got, oh, where's, this is the one I thought I liked the best. Look at this. How awesome is that? These are like 10 bucks, so they're not expensive. They got Timon and Pumbaa, if I remember. Yeah, there's Timon. I think Timon is pretty cool, and Pumbaa is back here in the back. And there's Pumbaa, so I think those are pretty cool. You guys can let me know in the comment section if you like those. I think they're pretty awesome. If you go down here, guys, they have the Turtles. So yeah, I'm kind of still on the fence with these things. One set's already gone because a viewer came here and bought the other set and messaged me on Instagram. But there's Leo and Shredder. I think these are really cool, guys. Honestly, I just the price tag, man. There's Donnie, Krang. I mean, these, I like the shading on them. The paint looks very, very good. There's Mikey, got a foot soldier. And the last one we got over here should be Raff. Yep, so there's Raff, another foot soldier. So these things are $52 per set. So if you want all of them, which, you know, you kind of got to get them all, you're talking over 200 bucks. Not a bad value, honestly, for what they are. But going to Toylana next Friday, 200 bucks could be another hot toy for me. So we'll see how that plays out, but yeah, so let's go see what they got over here at the boat, and maybe we'll find something. We've got these guys. I did buy this. I haven't shown it to anybody, but I did end up buying this two pack because, you know, Game of Thrones. And oh, look at this, they put 10 inch toothless out, actually not on the boat, so that's kind of crazy. 10 inch toothless sitting right here. How to Train Your Dragon, very cool. I am not collecting 10-inch pops anymore. I'm kind of done with that. This thing is huge. It's like the size of the Dobby box from Harry Potter. So there, and this is, should be the other TargetCon two-pack right there from Titanic. So there's those. So they've got these put out, which means they might have sold out of the other ones already. But let's go ask. They had everything. That was pretty cool. So I did buy a couple things. These are extras to help some people out. Maybe a giveaway? I don't know. We'll see how it goes. So I think we're going to go back to the studio and take some of these out of the box, check them out. So I'll see you there. I think we should just, I don't know, maybe like... All right, so we made it back. We're back in the studio, guys. So here's the thing. TargetCon 2019 was actually, well, it was pretty simple. It wasn't a big deal. Actually wasn't able to go at like opening. I know a lot of you guys were out there waiting in line. And from what the Target reps told me, there was a pretty good line this morning at Target.
Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get there when they opened, but I was able to go at like 9 o'clock. So ours opened at 8. I got there about 9. I also went back around lunchtime and, I got some stuff. So let's take a look at it, at the ones I picked up. And let me know in the comment section down below which ones you picked up. And let's see what the community went after. Now, I picked up 3 this morning. So let's figure out. Yeah, it was these 3. They had all of them. And one of the downsides of today was that I couldn't record a lot of stuff in the store because it was just a lot of employees around. And our Target had the pops in the boat or the electronics section. And there were just people. It was a weird deal. So for filming wise, kind of not all that great. But I did get some pops. So let's take a look at the first one. Yes. All right. So the first one, guys, we got glow-in-the-dark Darth Vader. We're definitely going to take a look at this one in the glow-in-the-dark cabinet that I built. Check that out. So this one's super cool. We're going to take this one out of the box in just a second. I did not get the common variant of this one because when I saw they were doing glow-in-the-dark, getting the common one didn't really make a lot of sense to me. So I'm going to put him right there with my AT-ST and my short trooper back there. So I got that one. We also picked up MJ. So this is going to be awesome next to the MJ I already own. So I've got the common variant that I've actually picked up at Foot Locker. Honestly, the Foot Locker one is way better in pop design. I know he's got different shoes. I get it. But just as a design, he's there standing with a basketball. It's kind of a boring pose. But it is MJ and it is Target exclusive. So I did want to pick that up. So I got MJ. And the last one I picked up this morning was... Yes, another one that's going in my cabinet, guys. Captain Marvel Glow in the Dark. Now, I will tell you, of all the Captain Marvel pops, these exclusives are flipping amazing. The pose on this thing is fantastic. Can't wait to check out the glow. I will show you guys some footage of the glow pops in the cabinet here in just a second. But you can check that thing out. That is a super, super awesome pop. So I got those 3 this morning. So around lunchtime, I went back. And I figured, well, if there's anything left over, I'll get some extras to help somebody out, maybe a friend of mine that need them, or maybe one of you guys out there in YouTube land that weren't able to get these. We'll kind of see what we got. So I did get some extras, and I got an extra Vader. So I got an extra one of those, and I'll put him right there. I got an extra, you guys, what did you get? I got an extra MJ. So I got another MJ. So I got that. So I got those because I thought somebody out there in the Facebook group, if you haven't already joined that, link in the description below, join the Facebook group. Or in the YouTube community that might need these, I'll hook somebody up with a good deal on these. So warning on that, I got to tell you about this, guys. I was on Facebook earlier today, and I noticed a lot of people, and it's not like I didn't know this was coming. I knew this was coming. But, I mean, people out there are savages, man. Savages. I saw, like, people buying these pops. These were $9 at Target, right? $9. And flipping them, or at least attempting to flip them for $50, $60, $70. The 10-inch pops, $100 for those. I'm going, what in the... Don't, guys, please do not pay those prices. Wait until the market settles, all right? Target will have restocks on these. I would bet money on that. They're going to have restocks on the website. Stay tuned. I'll put in the description below, I'll put a link to the actual items so you can follow those links and, you know, save them in your browser and whatever, check back. But yeah, don't pay flipper prices on these things, guys. These are not going to be super rare, especially like they're not limited. There's no numbers. They didn't make like 2,000 or 1,500 of these. These are not going to be super expensive. So number one, don't pay flipper prices for these. Right now, don't do it. Just wait it out. Be patient. That's my warning to you. Also, the people doing the raffles and the waffles and all that crap. I saw one of them today. It was $100 for a 10-inch pop, and it was like $70 or $50 for one of these things. I'm like, don't fall into that trap, guys. I know there's a lot of you guys out to do that, but when a pop drops day one, I'm telling you, it's a mistake. Don't do it. Don't feed into that crap. So that's pretty much what I've got for you today. Let's take these out of the box real quick, get a close look at them, and then we'll put them in the glow-in-the-dark cabinet, see how they look. All right, guys, first up, we have MJ. Check them out. It actually, you know, they got a good design on the actual basketball. They got the dimples on the ball. They got the shoes going on. Somebody out there in YouTube land will know what Jordan shoes these are. I have no idea. I'm not a sneakerhead. But there it is, guys, number 23 on the back. It's just a standard pop. There's really nothing super awesome about this pop other than it's got Jordan on the back, and it's number 23. It's pretty much like every other basketball pop they've made. There's really nothing special about this one. So that, you know, I am a Michael fan. I think he's the greatest. I'm just saying, I think he's the greatest. But as far as pop designs, the common one with the dunking pose is way better than this one. So that's that. Anybody paying crazy money for that thing, I think is just silly. All right, so next one up. This one is amazing. I really, really, really like this one. Now, here it is, Captain Marvel, guys. This is a flying pose right here. The glow-in-the-dark fire burst going on right there. I am curious to see how the glow is going to be on this. We'll check it out here in just a second. But it's a flight pose. The actual paint app is pretty cool. I think one of the things that's a little weird is the paint app on the helmet does not match the paint app on the body. And what I mean is the actual finish of it. It's kind of like a matte and metallic finish going on here, and then up here it's really it's plastic. I mean, you can tell it's plastic. It looks different. It's not as cool. But I think it's going to glow pretty well. I wonder if it's just here it's going to glow. Maybe the hair is going to. Probably just the fist. Probably just going to be that. So we'll put her right there. And then the one that I think is going to glow the absolute best is Vader. And Vader is heavy because he's stuck on this base as all the new Star Wars pops are. But I think this one right here, you can quit bobbling, Vader. But I think this one's super cool. And for whatever reason, it doesn't want to focus on Vader. Maybe it's afraid. Camera, are you afraid of Vader? Maybe you are. I don't know. Maybe it's just, I don't know. But we'll put him in the cabinet for whatever reason. Camera doesn't want to focus. Stick him in the cabinet, see what it glows. And that'll be the end of the video. So I want to say right now, before we get to that part, collect what you like. We'll see you next video.